Welcome back to Geek TV. My name's Jeremy. If this is your first time visiting the channel and you love anything self-hosted, home lab related, consider subscribing. If you like the video at the end, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Today, I'm going to be talking about something a little bit different. I'm kind of a bit of a data hoarder. And when I say data hoarding, I mean, I like to mostly hoard family videos, family photos, but really who doesn't? Linux ISOs, and that's kind of where it started. And then it just kind of snowballed into other things. And that's kind of where this comes in right here. And that is the Wikipedia, along with other sub-wikis and other wikis that are out there as well. Did you know you can self-host your own copy of Wikipedia? Millions of articles. It's a self-hosted wiki served up by Docker. I'm going to show you how you can self-host your own wikis. You can choose which sub-wikis you want to host. If you want to host everything you see here on my screen, you're going to need about 350 to 400 gigabytes of space. Now, considering you're going to be getting over 7 million articles, depending on which subs you decide to add to your server, that to me alone is worth it. And that's including images and videos in some cases. So let's dive in, take a closer look at Kiwix, and see what it's just all about. So what exactly is Kiwix? Well, Kiwix is a software that serves ZIM files. The ZIM file format is an open file format that stores wiki content for offline usage. Its primary focus is the contents of Wikipedia and other wiki projects. Well, that's great and all, but where can you get these ZIM files that you speak of? That's no problem. I prefer to get them right here from the Kiwix.org. Download archive. They have all of their ZIM files categorized into folders neatly right here on their directory. Let's take a closer look at the ZIM file, how they work, the naming convention, and what those specific parts of the naming convention mean. In this video, I'll be using the Wikipedia ZIM as the example. In this directory, we can see all of these different Wikipedia ZIM files, and there is a lot of them. And there's options. Let's talk about what this naming convention is exactly. At the beginning of the name, we have the Wikipedia, which is the name of the wiki sub. Next to that, we have AB, which is the language of the ZIM file. Then we have this thing called Maxi. And the other option is Mini. Maxi stands for the default or full version of the wiki. So in this case, you'll get the full version. With the Mini version, you would only get the introduction of each article plus info boxes, and it saves about 95% more space versus the full version, which is Maxi. You'll also see this option here called no pick. No pick simply means full articles but no images. So this is about 75% smaller than the full version, which is Maxi. And finally, for the last bit of the naming convention, we have the date in which this file was added to the directory. So you can see that this was added just this month. Okay, now that you know how Kiwix works, how the ZIM files work, kind of for the most part, let's install Kiwix. We're going to install it using Docker, and then we're going to take those ZIM files that we found in the directory, and we're going to add them into the Docker Compose file, which I'm going to show you how to do, and all this information will be on thehomelab.wiki, which I'll link in the description below. Let's install Kiwix. To install Kiwix, I'm using Portainer's Stacks Web Editor. And here you can see the stack that I'll be using with all of the ZIM files that I have within my data folder, which is mapped right here. I couldn't find a Docker Compose version of this image, so I went ahead and made my own, which you can find on thehomelab.wiki. You can just copy and paste it right into your Stacks web editor and Portainer. You'll just have to change out the ZIM files for the ones that you download to your server. In order to get these ZIM files into this data directory, we have to CD into it using our terminal. So you can see what the directory is called here. This is actually on my Open Media Vault server, so I'll show you how I get into it here using my terminal. You guys have seen this before. My favorite terminal tool is Solar Putty, and I happen to have BPyTop here running, but I'm going to close this out, and I'm going to CD into that directory that you just saw in the stack, which is this one right here. I am in that directory, so let's ls. In this directory, you can now see all of the ZIM files that I have in there. So this is where Docker is seeing all of the ZIM files. These files have to be in there in order for the Docker container to run. If there's no ZIM files in there, it won't run properly. But I'm going to start over fresh. I'm going to remove all of the files in here. So now there's no files in here at all. I don't have any ZIM files, which means sadly I'm going to have to re-download them all. But you know what? I'm going to have to anyways to show you guys how to do it. And let's get started doing that using wget. Okay, so let's go ahead and clear this out. If you don't have wget on your system, make sure you install that by running apt-get install wget. If you can't seem to find it, make sure you do an apt update and apt upgrade first, and then run apt-get install wget, and you should be able to install it. And of course, if you're on a machine that requires sudo, make sure you type in sudo first. But since I am using a Open Media Vault server, I'm already in as root, as you can see over here on the far left. So I don't need sudo. But in order to do this, you want to make sure that you are in the directory that your data folder is mapped to for the stack, for Docker, for Kiwix. So make sure that's done first. Make sure you're seeded into that directory, wherever it might be. And now we just have to go back to the Zim directory and grab a Zim that we want to put into our data directory. So let's go check out the directory and find a Zim that we might be interested in hosting. Okay, so this page might look familiar to you. We were just on this page a few minutes ago talking about the naming convention of the Zim files. And this is also where we're going to get the links so we can add the Zim files into our data directory over on our terminal. You can see that there's some big files here. This one's 82 gigs. This is the entire Wikipedia, which I'm not going to do the biggest one. I do have it and I enjoy having it, but for demonstration purposes, I'm going to do something that's much smaller. So I'm going to scroll down here and I'm going to find one that I like. I think this one will do. This is the top stories on Wikipedia. So I'm going to go ahead and grab this one. It's only 5.6 gigabytes. So to do that, I'm going to right click and then click on copy link. And then we're going to go back to our terminal. And don't forget, it's important that you are in the directory where your Zim files are going to live for the Docker container. We're going to type in wget, and then we're going to right click, and this will paste in the link for that Zim file, and it will download that into this directory. So this will take a few minutes to do. You can see the progress on the far right side here. It gives you an ETA. Here for me, it's telling me that it's going to take about 7 minutes. So I'll cut this off and get back with you guys when it's done. Okay, and just like that, it has finished. You can see the name of the file is right here. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this by just highlighting it. And then if we run an ls, we can list the files in here. We can see that the Zim file is in there. So now we have to go and run our compose stack in Portainer. So let's go do that now. This is what my stack looked like before, but since I don't have any of these Zim files in there anymore, I'm going to remove them all and I'm going to take what I copied from the terminal and I'm going to paste that right in here because this is the file name that the command is going to be looking for when I run the stack. And if you download more Zim files into the data directory, just make sure you put the name underneath this one. Just make a nice neat list here and then you'll just have to re-update the stack to have those changes take effect. So those wiki or subwikis will show up on Kiwix. You can get this over on the homelab.wiki where you can copy it and paste your Zim file names in as you need. So go ahead and give it a name and then we'll hit deploy the stack. If you need to change the port, you can do that as well. So we'll hit containers and then we can see that it is running here on 8080. So we can see Kiwix Serve here, and then if I click on 8080, and here it is. I zoomed in a little bit for you. So best of Wikipedia, a selection of the best 50,000 Wikipedia articles. Again, this was about five and a half, six gigabytes. So 50,000 articles, all with images. So if we click this, we can see all the different images, all the different people. So let's do an example here. Let's search for Beatles and see what we can find. We see an article that's all about the Beatles. And there's links here. We can click on Lennon and McCarthy, and this will take you to another article. You can click on, you can roll the dice to get a random article if you want. Death Squad, whatever this is. But this is the start of Kiwix, and you can see when you add more Zim files in here, it'll add more sub wikis in here that you can click on and browse through and search. So that's how you add your Zim files using wget. And the coolest thing about this is it's all self-hosted right on your own computer. Hardware, server, whatever it is that it's hosted on, it's easy to host because it's using Docker. If you want to, you can go back into the directory and grab all of the Zim files you want and create your own self-hosted wiki with Kiwix Serve. One example and something that I did was I set up an instance of Kiwix on a laptop locally using a copy of Ubuntu on my laptop. I set it up via Docker and I can take it with me anywhere I want. I have access to it locally, don't have to have the internet to access it. So I have millions of articles anywhere I want, basically a traveling Wikipedia. There is an Electron app called QXJS for Windows and Linux both that you can download to view your Zim files. For example, if you have Zim files maybe on a desktop somewhere, you can just download this, load up the Zim files in here and view them that way as well. Also within the settings of QXJS, There is also a way to download the zim files from the Kiwix server, so you can do it from here as well. That's going to wrap up today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and got some useful information from this. In fact, so much information you don't know what to do with. Consider giving me a thumbs up. If you are not a subscriber, consider subscribing. Make sure you click the bell icon so you don't miss a video on the channel. Don't forget, all of the information and show notes will be on the homelab.wiki. Information is in the description. Thank you so much for watching. That's it for today. Bye for now.